Right then, the Fiesta saga continues. So this was a Fiesta salvage car that we purchased, and before we started on it, the front end had a big massive V in it and was all damaged and the airbags had gone off and all that kind of stuff. So we've done all that work now. Now since then, there's been a little bit of a clutch slash transmission issue. Now it's been very stiff when trying to change down from third into second and first. So initially I thought there was an issue with the synchro hub for second and first, which might be causing it to mesh wrong or something like that. Now that could still be the case for the stiff gears. However, there's definitely an issue with the clutch hydraulics. There is either air getting in somewhere or fluid leaking back past the seal, causing it to be ineffective. And sometimes you can have the clutch on the floor, but the car's still trying to drive away. So with some testing, I've diagnosed it as a clutch master cylinder. So we're going to swap that out today and see if we can get it sorted. Right, start with then, what I'm going to do is take the scuttle panel off just to access the feed pipe for the clutch master cylinder off. So I've undone the 216s on the wipers, little push down, they will disconnect. Like so, move them out of the way. Right, then, what I'm going to have to do is take the headlights out, so two Torx 30s and these lights just snatch out of the holes, and then take these clips here off the scuttle, disconnect that, and then there's a lower portion to come out as well.
So that noise is just them fixed this and getting it.
Yeah, it's not anything breaking, it's just that this has a prong. If I show you on the headlight,
they are very stiff.
There's a little prong there that just sits down into that white receptacle there. And obviously as you snatch it out, the clip snaps forward, so.
It just sounds like you're breaking
everything. It does, it always feels like you are as well. Right, okay, let's retrieve these clips then. Oh. Now these just hold the two pieces of the scuttle together. So they're just metal slide on tabs like so. Slide these off and the top section comes away. Be a bit fiddly, just be careful you don't drop them into your engine bay.
Sure, getting close up.
Last thing you want.
They're not the sort of thing you've normally got lying around the toolbox either.
No, exactly. They're always one of them that's you've got to order from dealer or whatever. Or should we say stealer. Luckily that one hit the floor. Brilliant, I've seen where that one went.
So that was obviously done on purpose to show you what not to do.
Of course, obviously. Obviously. Okay, top section then, with a bit of wiggling, will come loose. Obviously there's going to be some crud around it and things like that, so you have to disconnect it from the scrapers that sit up the side of the windscreen here as well. Oh, it's to that, thank you, Dan. Right, take that out of the way. Okay. Right, lower section then, it's quite easy. It's just a bunch of 10 mils. There's one there, one at the back, and then same on the other side, and then that lower section comes out and gives us a bit more access. Doesn't give you mega access this, but it gives you enough just to be able to get your arm down and pull the retaining clip out of the feed pipe for the clutch hydraulic fluid, or brake fluid we should say, as these are fed off the brake fluid reservoir.
So I suppose the question that could come up then with that is, if you're messing around with the clutch system and it's fed from the brake reservoir, is that going to need the brake bleeding afterwards as well?
Right, so no, it can result in that if you let the fluid level drop too low for the brake feed pipe out of the reservoir. But the idea is, especially on these, they actually want you to reverse bleed the clutch. So technically you'll be pushing fluid back in from the slave cylinder all the way up to the reservoir there. So essentially it's a case of trying to, when you pull the feed pipe out of the clutch, cap it off so you don't lose too much fluid. Okay, so just one of the little breather pipes there just to pop out. And then that's the lower section off and out of the way. So, fair amount of stripping, but it's all quite straightforward and easy. As you can see, it doesn't give us mega access, but we can now actually get down there without all that plastic in the way. So
less than 10 minutes and you're at that stage.
Well, yeah, that's true. Just a few minutes and you can get to this stage. So it's not a massively complex job. Once we've got the feed pipe off and the feed pipe for the slave cylinder, the next bit is all inside the car, and that's quite straightforward as well. Right, let's see what access we have got then. It sits just below the servo there. The light is completely throwing me off. Okay, right, I'll tell you what.
There's not a huge amount of room, is there?
No, there isn't. What we'll do, we'll go inside the car and show what we have to do in there, because it may even be that as I drop it through the bulkhead, there's enough way I can actually operate it inside the car and just catch the brake fluid. But either way, we've got to disconnect the steering column. Now, anyone that's not done this before, don't let that make you too nervous. It's literally a 10 mil bolt. You slide it off. When you slide it back on, it seats nicely into its own position. So let's go and show you what that looks like. So under here then, what we have is our clutch pedal there with the master cylinder all integrated, and then we've got our steering column here. So essentially you have to pull this boot away here, and that's going to expose that 10 mil bolt, and then it's just a universal joint. So you undo that 10 mil, slide it up out the way, and that gives you access to the bolts that are holding the pedal assembly onto the bulkhead. Okay, so there's the steering column off then. As you can see, the stub that's just there with the little groove ground into it. Now, that's the groove the bolt sits in to stop it falling off when you put it back on. So basically, as long as you seat that down nicely and you make sure the bolt goes through and engages that groove, you're not going to get any problems with it coming off or wobbling loose. I don't know how well you're going to see on camera, but just down here where I'm pointing this pick, you'll see there's a little circlip in the pipe. So you have to draw that back to that position. Don't pull any harder than that, because it is one of those that stays in the housing. So once you've drawn that back, you'll be able to pull that feed pipe off, and that comes from the master cylinder to the slave cylinder. And then all we have then is the top hose. On this, because of the access, I may end up taking the top hose off the brake reservoir just up here and taking it back through the bulkhead with the pedal, and then vice versa when I refit it, because it's quite tricky to get to the actual union that's on the bulkhead on the back of the pedal there, because there's just no access down the back with the aircon pipe in the way. So I've undone the three 13 mils then, one that goes there, one that goes there, and one on the other side that's just tucked up there. Good idea to use a good long extension with this, because it just makes it easier and faster, and now the pedal will actually pull back and retract. So the wiring clip here for the clutch sensor, just on the side, you can see that grey plug. You just need to follow that up with your hand and then unclip it from the side of the pedal body itself. Sorry about the light there. I'm using this little footwell light and it's going everywhere. And then once you've unclipped that, the pedal assembly will come away. So there we are, one clutch pedal assembly out with the master still in that inside, as you can see. So what I had to do, because the access was so poor, is I had to disconnect this pipe from the actual brake fluid reservoir itself rather than the pedal, but it came out with it. So what we're going to do then is we'll now disconnect it from the master cylinder so we can put this to one side. And it's actually quite an easy pushback clip, just as simple as that, and it will hold itself in position. But we can put that to one side now and then put that back on when the new cylinder's in. So to get the cylinder out, well, there's a couple of more plugs as well that you've got to unplug when it's in the car, which is one here and then one on the top here on this other clutch sensor. Now, next thing is we've got to get the pedal out. There's a little white plug, like a pin here. On the other side, it has some pushing tabs. So basically what we have to do is sort of push those in and then lever the other side outwards. And it's a bit fiddly, this. It's not too bad, but you just keep working at it and that'll slide out and then the pedal will come away, which is obviously connected to the top of the master cylinder. Right, so there's the little hinge pin out then. So then all you've got to do to get the cylinder out is there's two Torx 30s here. They're fairly tight, so you either want to secure it on a bench or use an impact gun. There's a couple of nuts on the other side that you've just got to hold as well once you've slackened them off. So I'll get the socket now and we'll hold those.
If you haven't got a bench, a wheelie beam works just as well.
Absolutely. Of course it does. Fairly substantial bolts, but obviously there's a lot of force you put on the clutch pedal while you're operating it. Right, second one. Lovely, cheers to that. Okay, there we go. So, we'll be able to wrestle that master cylinder free now and then put the new one in. Right, so at this point, this is the new cylinder. I've just put this foam over the top. I can give you a closer look at exactly what was going on down in the engine bay when you have to remove that retaining clip. So essentially what you do is you just want to pull that back until it sits in that position. As you can see, it's housed there against that little notch, and it also does the same on the bottom end. And that, as you can see, that cap just fell out. Now, that's the great thing about it is you get a new one with a new cylinder, and they do like to ping off and disappear. So if that happens, we know we've got a spare one from the old cylinder. And then the top one is just a cap that you just slide the pipe on and clamp it on as it goes anyway. So that's what you do. Set that in that position, get rid of the little cap, and then we'll start to assemble it back in the pedal. Right, if you're doing this job on your Fiesta, don't forget that when you've got the old master cylinder out, there is a plug for the start-stop system here that you have to take off and put onto the new cylinder. Would have about it the right way up, wouldn't it? Just in there, look. Slide that on, and then that's ready to plug back in when it goes in the car. So that will just clip onto a little retainer that's just there, and then once you've got it in, then that'll hold itself in place. You can just offer that plug back up. Right, everything's back together. So refit is just reversal of removal. Now, on these Fords, they like you to reverse bleed them, which is basically pushing fluid in from the gearbox, the slave cylinder end, back up to the reservoir. Apparently, if you do it the normal way, the traditional way, you can blow or pop the slave cylinder. So, got myself a decent sized syringe here, 100ml syringe.
Stolen syringe.
Sorry, Dan. Yeah, Dan did buy it for another purpose, but unfortunately, I've now pinched it for this, so never mind. Anyway, let's just make sure we purge all the air out of that, and then we can pull it up level. I'm going to fill it up because you can always put back in the bottle what you don't use. There we go. And it shouldn't take a massive amount anyway to be able to actually get this system filled. They're only thin diameter pipes. Just trying to stay as clean as I possibly can whilst doing it, that's all. Okay, right, so to be able to access the bleed nipple then, it's best to pop the air box out because it's just there on the front of the gearbox, and a 14mm spanner will undo it because it's a plastic bleed nipple. You just undo it about 3/4 of a turn and then that's open, ready to receive fluid. Now, the only problem is I need another pair of hands to hold the syringe up in the air while I put the pipe on the nipple, so we'll get that on and then we'll come back to you then. So I've removed the lid from the reservoir, as you can see over there, just to make sure we don't get any airlocks while we're pushing back through, so that the air can escape. And then you want it, you're going to open that bleed nipple a good bit, but then you don't want to go mad. Don't try and pump it in too fast or put loads and loads of pressure on. You just want it, and then if you look at the level on the reservoir, you'll see that's climbing back towards max, and you'll see the air coming out. So basically, as soon as that hits max, we stop, lock off that bleed nipple, and that's the system reverse bled. Easy as that. Okay, we are about there, I reckon, Dan, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I'd say so.
Excellent, right. So I'll just keep a little bit of pressure on that while I close up that bleed nipple then. Of course, there's zero access for anything on this car, this included. Okay, that is closed off and locked into position. Perfect. Okay, so that's as easy as that then. What we do now, remove this, obviously mop up any brake fluid spillage, but that should be the clutch working. So I'll pop all the scuttle and everything back together, and then we'll come back in a minute, fire the car up and see if we've got some drive. So before tackling this job then, the main problem with the clutch pedal, like I explained, was that it was dead spongy. Some days it was okay, some days it was spongy like there was air in there. Other days I could have the clutch on the floor and the car would still be trying to drive. So you could always feel a difference in the pedal. But now we've got a nice firm pedal. There's plenty of feedback all the way through. Let's fire it up. It used to crunch a lot into reverse as well. Like way worse than that, that's acceptable. Okay, and it's slotting into first really nicely. So that feels like a job well done and a problem solved. So I'm going to get it out on the road now, see if it's cured up the stiff gear changes. If not, then we'll need to look internally into the gearbox, but we'll see at the end of the video whether that's fixed. Okay, so it has massively improved those stiff gear changes, and nowhere near as bad as they were, but it's still a little bit awkward getting it down into second. You do have to line it up with first still, but there's nowhere near as much effort required. So I think maybe then we'll see how it goes for a few days, see if there might be a little bit of air left in the system that itself bleeds out. But all else failing that, I've got a replacement gearbox for it anyway, so we'll get that off and we'll swap the clutch and the slave cylinder while we're in there. So that's it for this one. If you want to see any more technical videos like this or any of our absolute nightmare projects that we've got going on, subscribe to the channel. It's massively appreciated. You don't realize how much it helps us, and we can keep bringing you great content like this. So until then, we'll see you in the next one.